Cross Squad.
And welcome back to the Sean Cross Channel. This is another Front to Back session. And this morning at 7:05 a.m., we are actually going back in time a little bit. And we are checking out the only major release by Awakened Providence that we have not yet listened to. That being the EP Insidious Phase 2, featuring, you know, the original vocalist, Will Ramos. Let's get into it.
I smile at the dead.
On the right audio channel. There we go. Ah, it's just a quiet track.
I'm not your friend, you're right now. What's in front of me?
Yeah.
appointment asleep. Life in dreams. Take me away, take me aside, my country.
there's the music video from back in 2017, man. He dreamed Darius from Spite. Sweet. So that was the Awakened Providence Insidious Phase 2 album, EP, whatever you wish to call it. It is an 8-track record, so I would definitely consider it an album according to industry standards. But let's go ahead and dive right into the review, right? So, as far as context, we don't really have anything lyrically to go off of, so we'll just have to leave that neutral. And I think from now on, unless of the front-to-back session ends up being the result of an under-the-skin session, like doing the other skin before and then going to front-to-back, we'll definitely just have to leave that out from now on. But vocally speaking, I mean, this is Will Ramos we're talking about, but this is early Will Ramos. This is early Darius. This is early Brian Long, Ben Doerr, Dickie Allen. So many amazing vocalists who ended up featuring on this EP alongside Will Ramos. But I think that even early on, Will has always been a very iconic vocalist. He knows what to do. And I mean, this was also like their first full length, I think, their first like 8-song EP. There is another EP slash album before this called Serpents that I'll have to check out at some other point. But he knows what to do. He knows how to do it. He brings a whole bunch of different things to the table. And I mean, whether on Pain Remains or And I Return to Nothingness, which is, that's all Lorna Shore, or Insidious Phase 2 so far, absolutely fantastic. So I would give it a 10 out of 10, even for an EP slash album that was released back in 2017. as far as the instruments are concerned, the sound, the production. I am not exactly a producer myself. I'm not a sound engineer myself yet. So there's not really much professional insight I can offer, except that the only thing I didn't enjoy about the production, the sound, was that, you know, because it was in 2017, everything was still a little suppressed and it was a little compressed. People didn't really know how to navigate the production of deathcore, black and deathcore, whatever you want to call this, as well back then. So naturally speaking, it sounds a little bit muffled compared to the music of anywhere from 2019 to now, but still sounds pretty good. And it's Awaken Providence, after all. This was before they had DeAndre doing backing vocals. So that's also something that's kind of missing from this. I could easily add that to the vocal rating, but I won't. So I would give the instrumentals, the sound, a solid 8 out of 10, just because, like, now I have been conditioned and I have adapted and become comfortable with the sound engineering of the last couple years. As far as the album cover, the general visuals, the logo, their logo is iconic. The EP cover for Insidious Phase 2, well, it's a sequel to the original track Insidious, which was a standalone single, and I think it works really well, and I'm curious on, like, going back and listening to those songs now, Serpents and the standalone track Insidious. I would give the cover and the art an 8 out of 10. It's pretty good, but it could be better. And again, this is Black and Deathcore back in 2017. So things were different back then. They thought probably that simple was better and that, you know, less is better. And that's completely fine. I understand. So I think overall thoughts would be that this EP, this album, it definitely, like, takes you back in time to before they decided to add a whole bunch of different stuff into their sound, that being Awaken Providence. And after the departure of Will Ramos, they're like, okay, someone's got to fill the plate, someone's got to fill the spot. And I'm so glad that they decided on Adam Mercer, because he is a really, really good vocalist. But this has been Sean Cross doing another Front to Back session with maybe, I would say, 16 minutes left to go ahead and check out other music. Hope you guys enjoyed. I sure as hell did. And until next time, until tomorrow morning, let the great eternal music machine keep cranking.